I'm not a physician, but my opinion as a researcher, I would say it's looking pretty promising in terms of cardiovascular health. We have already talked about reducing A1C without medications and how that's going to benefit. Maintaining a lower A1C is beneficial in terms of cardiovascular risk. And if you look at all of the independent risk factors of cardiovascular disease, A1C, weight, markers of inflammation, blood pressure, and you look at our trial outcomes, you see all of those things improve after a year. Triglycerides are going down, HDL is going up, weight is going down, inflammation is going down when we measure high sensitivity CRP. If we're seeing all of those markers that are generally markers of cardiovascular risk improve over the year as a result of eating a low carbohydrate diet, then I would think that this is pretty beneficial for cardiovascular health.
The other marker that we didn't study or haven't analyzed so far in the one-year study is the blood level of saturated fat. Now, there's been a lot of debate about saturated fat and heart health, and the idea that eating a lot of saturated fat is dangerous for you has, you know, the diet heart hypothesis has been, you know, seriously questioned, if not completely disproven in the last few years. But we know that the amount of saturated fat in the bloodstream is strongly correlated with heart attack risk and diabetes risk. So Jeff Volek and I, in a previous study, not with diabetes, but patients with metabolic syndrome, over a 12-week period of time where they're eating, one group was assigned to a low-fat, high-carbohydrate diet, and the other group was randomized to a well-formulated ketogenic diet. And the people on the ketogenic diet were eating three times as much saturated fat as the people on low-fat diet. After 12 weeks, guess what happened to the blood levels of saturated fats? They were higher in the people on the low-fat diet and lower in the people on the high-fat diet. And how can you explain that? You know, because we've all been told you are what you eat. Actually, you are what you save from what you eat. And when you're keto-adapted, the body's ability to burn fat is markedly enhanced, and saturated fats are rapidly oxidized, so they can't build up in the body. So that other risk factor, which is harder to measure, you know, we physicians can't order a blood test for saturated fat levels. Sure. It's a specialty test. But when we made the effort to look at that, it's clear that when people are keto adapted, they're prevented from accumulating saturated fats. And even that factor will be eliminated as well.